In the classical situations of acting, the information principle was reduced to the sign, to a sign that makes you act. There's in Sueton is this, the Roman historiographer. There's a nice episode when he describes Caesar's hesitation when he is resting with his army on the northern side of the Rubicon. He does not really know what to do. And one day he took a decision by interpreting a strange fact that on the other side of the river, a young, almost naked man, blonde, playing on a flute, was sitting. And Caesar jumped on the occasion and said, "This is Dionysus who gave us a hint. And now let's go and to fulfill what the unjustness of our enemies and the rightness of God command to us." You know? And then he went beyond the Rubicon. There's always a connection between the disinhibition of the act of act, of the acting, the passage à l'acte. Yeah? In final analytical terms, there must always happen a moment when the discontinuity between motivation and project has to be bridged. And the bridging very often happens by the decision to take one particle of this informational environment more seriously than others.